I learned a long time ago that you should never discourage students from doing impossible things, because they often try and do impossible things and do them.
One of the things we've done at Bristol is to focus a lot on group-based project work, where we give students the opportunity to work in teams.
In the final year, we actually get them to come up with their own ideas.
That's when they can actually produce something as the high quality that we got from these projects.
So our mission was to revolutionise supermarket shopping using mobile apps, machine learning and real-time data.
It was originally motivated by the observation that a lot of people were getting frustrated by waiting in queues at supermarket checkouts.
So with the weather app, like, before you go shopping, you just log in with a simple press of a button. You get to the store,
scan the barcode off the product using the Bazaar app, click on checkout and pay.
You know who is shopping in the store, so you can provide online analytics to the store manager and he can make bespoke offers as he goes along through the day.
The really great thing about our project was we were able to actually deliver it in a real store. So as part of our marking day, we actually took the lecturers and the markers down to a local convenience store.
And we were buying chocolate bars with our smartphones. So who knows, maybe we'll see it around sometime soon.
Our final year project was working with a local arts festival in Bedminster and to help them create a digital guidebook to provide to their visitors.
They worked closely with a local arts organisation who actually needed the application that they developed, and I know for a fact that they're using it. They looked at both sides of the coin in the sense that they viewed it from the user point of view, someone who's actually doing an art trail with their app, but then they also thought about the organisation that were going to set that up.
So this is like the admin panel for the organisers and the exhibitors to go and insert information.
I think you could really believe that people would use it and want to come back for more.
We worked on the Open Transmuter, which is an open source microprocessor based on the Transmuter.
The Transmuter was the first microprocessor that was designed for parallel computing as a component from which could be used to build complex systems out of collections of processors.
It found its way into simple applications such as set-top boxes for TVs and things like that, up to spacecrafts that are actually working up there.
This is core computer science. There's some serious chip design in there, but they took that idea and sort of, if you like, brought it up to the future.
We took what some of the work that was already done at IDMOS and we redesigned all the implementation to take advantage of state-of-the-art technology so that it would be smaller, faster and cheaper.
In some ways, it's an improvement on the original from some of the changes that have been made. And it's rather remarkable that it was done by two students. The original one, I think, had a team of 20 or so designing it. But we did have to do things a little differently in those days.
The idea is, whilst you're at an outdoor festival or an event that's outdoors,
you click a single button on your smartphone and our system will automatically kind of send a drone over to you. It will frame it automatically, it will take a picture of you, and then you can choose to have that photo put on Facebook or download it or whatever you want to do.
When the students start their projects, they've mapped out the practicalities, the software they have to build and so on. And then they start to do the project and suddenly they hit obstacles.
It was an issue that came up straight away with this project. Would it be actually okay to have a drone flying around, you know, in a venue with thousands of people there? They quickly realised that whatever the law is at the moment, it's going to get adjusted to make it possible to fly drones around. There are just too many people who want to do it.
We've purposely made the user interface, especially from the user's point of view, very, very simple. They click one button and all this kind of stuff triggers off in the background, and it just sort of, you know, a drone checks its motors, it checks whether it's got enough battery life, it then will take off, it will then try and turn to the right kind of angle to head to the user, it will generate a path to get there safely. It does all these things and kind of, you know, the user will only ever see that kind of one button press and that photo out of it.
We worked on a project called Nimble. And Nimble consisted of two parts. There was the band, and there was also an operating system.
You should just be able to walk up to any screen, click your name, double tap a wristband of some kind, and just be logged in and have everything exactly where you left off, no matter what screen you've walked up to.
There's a real buzz about that project that you think actually that could work and people could sell that.
We took the breadboarded design and turned it into a PCB that we got fabricated, and that involved talking to manufacturers in America, China, Europe, and also coordinating with the chip manufacturers.
So it was quite a big operational challenge as well.
Once we had the circuit board assembled, we needed basically to design a wristband to put them in. We were able to use an array of 3D printers that the University Engineering Department have.
It's astonishing that they went from nothing at all and very little experience of hardware design to producing that device in 3 months effectively. And then when you look at the quality of the what's been delivered in terms of the user interface and the way the whole thing just appears on screen and things of the styling of the whole thing, it's just very impressive.
This is our OS, and if you walked up to any screen running our system, this is what you'd see. As long as I have an internet connection, I can be anywhere in the world and access my files. Much like Dropbox is for just files, this is for your whole OS.
I mean, there are a lot of different things there. There's the communication software, there's the software that's the cryptography that goes into the authentication device. And then, of course, there's the 3D design of the device itself. So all these different things that we teach them in different parts of the curriculum get drawn together in these bigger projects. That's the beauty of it.
I've been astounded at the level that they can achieve.
I think as a team, you're able to achieve much more than if you were working on something individually.
You all think, oh, it'd be so cool if we could all do this and we could all set this really optimistic goal. And actually, when you're working together, you find a way to make that happen.
What also came out of this project is that we got hired. So like all this time we were working at a company, I basically loved the project and they were like, do you guys want to work for us?
When you suddenly realise at the end of that project that you collectively built something much bigger and more impressive than you could have done yourself, that is a life-changing experience. That means you can now have bigger dreams.